Let's face it, there are some people that you want to receive emails from, and there are other people that you hope never make it to the inbox. Well, in Gmail, you can easily block those senders. Okay, so here we are in Gmail, and I have an email in my account that I no longer want to receive emails from the sender. It's just Adobe Acrobat, but let's say it's either a personal contact that I don't want emails from, or it could be something commercial. What are my options? Well, first of all, we could report this email as spam using this button up here at the top. Now, what this will do is it will send this individual email to our spam folder, and it will notify Google to try and identify emails like this in the future more easily to improve their spam filters. But does it block that sender from sending you emails in the future? No, it doesn't. Now, sometimes when you report spam, if they have an unsubscribe link in the bottom of the email, Google will offer to unsubscribe you as well. And if you choose to do that, you likely won't receive emails from that sender in the future. However, if it's a personal contact and you report it as spam, you're probably still going to get future emails. Just reporting as spam does not block the user. So how can we block this sender? Generally speaking, opening emails aren't really going to add any viruses. They're not dangerous from a security perspective. It's when you act on an open email. So when you download something or when you click on a link and then enter some personal information, that's when you get phished. So just opening the email is okay. So with the email open, what we're going to do is we're going to go to the three little dots on the right side of the email. And you'll notice that there's an option to block Adobe Acrobat. So if we select that option, it kind of gives us a confirmation, letting us know that future messages from Adobe Acrobat will be marked as spam. So we can go ahead and block that sender. And now any new emails that come from that email address will automatically go to our spam. And you'll notice that when we open up any emails from this sender, we have this message right here at the top, which is one of the easiest ways to unblock senders. You'll notice that there's a button right here to unblock this sender. Now, that's great. We can block them easily by using the three little dots, and we can unblock them by going into an email from them. However, what if I can't find any emails from that sender? Well, I'll show you another way. What we can do is we can go up to the top right corner of Gmail and click on the gear icon to access our Gmail settings. From here, we can click See All Settings. If Gmail updates the user interface, the button might look a little different, but it's always in your Gmail settings. This hasn't changed in like 10 years. So from within your Gmail settings, you're going to go to the tab that says Filters and Blocked Addresses. And from here, you'll notice there's a list of everyone that you've blocked in your Gmail account. Now, this is my test account, and I've only blocked Adobe Acrobat, but if I had blocked, say, 100 people, they would all be listed here. And I can select them with the checkboxes, and then I can choose to unblock the selected address. Okay, great. We know how to block and unblock senders in Gmail on a desktop computer. But does it work in the mobile app? Yes, it does. So let me just show you. I'm recording on the phone. So, okay, so I've now gained control of my iPhone, and I'm here in the Gmail app. So we can do some of the same things in the Gmail app on mobile that we can on the desktop. So I could open up an email, say this Adobe Acrobat email. And from here, we actually want to tap on not the three dots at the very top, but the second three dots next to where it says Adobe Acrobat. And you'll notice from these three dots, we have the option to block Adobe Acrobat. And if they were already blocked, we would have the option to unblock them. So I can just hit block. And you'll notice that I now have the message at the top of the email that says you've blocked mail at mail.adobe.com. But how can I unblock them if I don't have an email? Obviously, I could unblock them just by tapping that button right there. Well, what we can do is we can go back to the main screen here in Gmail. We're going to go to the top of our Gmail inbox, and we're going to tap on the three lines to the top left. From here, we're going to go to our Gmail settings at the very bottom of the list. And from within our settings, we're going to actually tap on Account at the very top. And you'll notice that we have this area that says blocked users. This is actually kind of difficult to find because there isn't, say, a privacy section or a filters and blocked addresses section like there is on desktop. And so from here, I could tap on blocked users and I could manage all the users that I've blocked. And you'll notice that in this list, it says I don't have any blocked users. That's because for whatever reason, it takes some time for your block list to update here in the Gmail app. So if you've just blocked somebody, they might not be showing up right away, but hopefully after at least a couple hours, they should appear in this list. And if they don't, sometimes Google has some disconnections between their products, unfortunately. If they don't, you can always go back on the desktop and use the method that I showed you at the beginning of this video. So there you have it. You should be easily able to control who can send you emails in Gmail by blocking users and then managing the blocked users in the Gmail settings. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, I would really appreciate a thumbs up here on YouTube. Don't forget to check out my other Gmail tutorials, which are right here. And if you want to see more videos like this one, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. That's all I have for you for today. This is Anson from AnsonAlex.com.